really edgy thing where I don't have a PowerPoint. And I'm going to be so brave working with the live internet. So my first question to you is, how many people would call yourself a librarian or an information specialist? Most people? Yeah, in the broader sense. How many people would regard yourselves as a librarian or information specialist or somebody who is data aware? Data savvy? Data expert? So, as librarians and professionals, information professionals, we don't need to be data experts. Our role basically is data guides, and you might be a guide in places that you never thought you would work. I regard myself as a librarian, and I haven't worked in a library now for 8 years. But I regard the core work that I do every day and the paradigms that I work with are absolutely taken from that library and information science world. So even if you don't end up ever working in a library or even ever working with data, and you will, then, you know, this is really, you're in an amazing position in the world. It's almost like we're poised for the next great leap forward. It's like it's the start of the Industrial Revolution. This is the start of the information age, and you're in an absolutely wonderful position to support that change in a positive way. So here we have the library catalogue for data. So if you had somebody who was looking for research data, how many people here have been in a road accident? Ever? Thank you for contributing your data. So if you look at this, I'll just see if I can make the screen a bit bigger. I typed in research data road accident, road accidents. You can see here I've got Monash University, I've got infrastructure.gov, I've got keepyoureyesontheroad.org, non-for-profit, Transport New South Wales, More Transport New South Wales, Queensland, Science Direct, I've got pictures, Victorian Government, QUT, I've got university data. So one simple four-word search has resulted in an incredible richness of data. If I wanted something that was more specific, let's try marine. So, those of you who think, what was this ANZ people were talking about? It's the Australian National Data Service, and we're a federally funded group. If those of you who might know the term NCRES, which is that roadmap that Steve was talking about, it's part of that. So it's part of ensuring that the infrastructure, I for NCRES is infrastructure, that infrastructure is around long after the projects fade away or get lost. And one of our roles is researchdataands.org.au. That is the embryonic, but getting better every day, National Research Data Library Catalogue. Mm. So, yes, it's small, but also too, when we were looking before and we were saying data.gov, 23,000 data sets, tip of the iceberg. Where's all the others? And it's the same here. So, people would know they can look in Google and you can get some really good results by simply calling up your best friend here, Dr. Google, and as usual, they will deliver. If you know a little bit about research data, what you can do is type in another acronym. And ta-da! The Terrestrial Ecosystem Research Network, home. Birds come third after Twitter. So if you go to TERN, and you'll see here there's a data discovery portal. So if you know a little bit, you can start at Google, And then if you know a little bit more, you know that there are domain or discipline, research discipline based portals that you can go to that you would get to know after a little while. Another thing you might want to look up is, I'll just put in ANZ.org. So ANZ.org.au, and why are we .org and not .gov or .edu or .something more exciting than .org? Makes us sound like RSPCA for data. And sometimes we do data rescue. So basically it's because we span all of it. We span education, we span government, and increasingly as our government moves towards our innovation agenda, we'll also span .gov, .biz, .com, .whatever. So this is basically how it works, and I apologise for that horrible banner at the top. I really can't. So I'll put in Marie. Okay. So this will take you to Research Data Australia, and you'll see that there are about 1,069 data sets that would be called marine. And again, yes, it's very broad. If you wanted to search by subjects, you can browse by subjects. So it's about 130,000 data sets in here. Some of them are tiny data sets, and some of them are huge, absolutely huge. And our role is to, there's about 110 contributors to Research Data Australia, and our role is to enable the infrastructure feeds to pull the data from all of those places, such as every university in Australia, every state government, every medical institute is slowly feeding data in. Some of it's very little, the tap is just being turned on. But in a few years' time, that will be a torrent. And this will be one place that aggregates the research data for everywhere. So you can see that within a couple of minutes, you can find research data. But the place you're probably not going to find it is in your library catalogue. Have a think. Is it? For those of you who are currently working in libraries, if somebody came to you and said, can I have data with my search, please? Would you say, no problem? Or would you say, eek? Arrange professional face rapidly. Not a problem, that's a great reference question. I'll tell you what, what's your contact? And I'll do some work for you and I'll get back to you. Well, you go. So one of the things that you have to think about is, if I can do this, it's a bit like a travel agent. If I can do this, without any reference to you, then what's your role? What's your role as a data librarian or as a librarian or in the data age, in the absolute age of data, where do you sit? Well, it's not all doom and gloom. So the first thing is that your potential role is about being a data guide. All the stuff that we've heard this morning about knowing a little bit about data management, licensing, can't I reuse that data? They're the things that your users and your clients and your patrons, they don't know. Nobody cares about standards, you do know. So when they say, this is great data, can I reuse it? And you think, I'll just check the license for you. So all the stuff around the data is the stuff where you have huge value add. And for those of you who are thinking, oh, of course, but how do I find out about it? Some of you are doing courses at uni, then you can make sure that you include any data stream that goes with it. For those of you who are done with HEX, done with studying, and you want something that you can do, we have a 23 Research Data Things program, and it's absolutely aimed at information professionals. It's got three levels, so it's got simple, just tell me what I need to know and nothing else, and then it's got, oh, I'm really interested in this, can I have a bit more? And then the third level is challenge me, and that's for people who think, I am in love with licensing. It's true, people are in love with licensing. And I want to know everything I possibly can. You might choose to do all three of those things. So up the back of the room, I've got some 23 things posters, and it's all open, you just do it yourself. And you can get together in groups. We've got some people who are doing their master's degree and they wanted to do data, but it wasn't offered. And so they got together and they do one thing a week and they meet online for 15 minutes a week and just say, oh, I did this thing, what did you think?